أهلا وسهلا، أهلا وسهلا يا شباب. Which means hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Or better said, hello and welcome, guys and girls. Welcome back. In the first video, in the part one, we set up the Linode instance. And now let's move on to setting up the name service for the domain. So open up your Linode dashboard. Here on the left, you see I'm on Linode right now, but we have to go to domains. Now I want to create a domain. And my domain just is this one, amazo.ai. You should set up also an email address for it. This is my email address, habibicoding@aol.com. We don't need, this can be like it is, do not insert default records for me. It's like fine how it is. Just say create domain. And just wait a second. And then we have some values there, as you can see. Now we have the NS record, the name servers, and we need those. We need those because now we will take those and copy them. Like this is world for you where I have set up my domain where it is purchased, and it will be, I think, the same for every domain provider. Just go to domains, go to the name server of your selected domain, and here you can edit the name servers. I already have here NS1 and NS2 linode.com, but I will of course add. As you can see, we have here 5 name servers. I will add as much as possible. I'm just allowed here to add 4, but it's okay. Say add one more. And when I say ns.4, as you can see, it got already suggested for me because I already did it for the medium.com article. Say update. Yeah, it can take some time. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. If you can enter 5, because as you can see, I couldn't enter the 5th one. Do it, but yeah, as you can, and I can tell you, 4 are also more than enough. But regards here, it's better to have more. This should now update. Hopefully, as you can see now, it's updated. That's good. Okay. So next, what we are going to do is we are navigating back to Linode, going to Linode, and copy this IP address. Yes, copy it. Go back to domains. Select now your domain. And we will add some A records so that the redirection works from our domain provider. For me, it's now world for you. For you guys, might be Google domains or Hostinger or GoDaddy or I don't know. And now we will do the redirection from the domain provider to our cloud provider instance. And just typed for the first entry an add here. The IP address, I copied it from before. So just paste it here, say save, nice, latif, bilarabi. And add another one. You can add a wildcard domain right now. If you want, like the wildcard would be with not this one, the asterisk here with the IP address, say save. And now you see we have here 2 entries, amazo, and you could also do it with www or any subdomain you have, would be the same procedure. Like you could say www or I don't know api.amazo blah blah blah, but I don't need it right now. So as you can see, these two entries are fine, but now to make things move faster, the domain name server propagation for the redirection, because the DNS works like a telephone book where it sees, okay, which top level domain, which servers hold this top level domain dot AI, and it will ask, okay, which top level domain knows where Emezo is for the Emezo.ai, and so on and so forth. I explained very, very bad right now, but yeah, you just Google up DNS propagation and how name servers work, or in general how DNS works. You will find a better explanation. But yeah, there are 13 root DNS servers, and those one knows which ones hold which IP for the domain. I hope this was a little bit better now, but yeah, let's just move on. Add the DNS record. So now just we can just say, okay, like add here, type is an A record. The value would be the new IP address we have. Like you see this IP address here from our Linode instance must be also inserted here on your domain provider once to make DNS propagation faster at DNS record. And now you see we have one A record here. And yes, you can add one more like we did before with the asterisk and type again the same IP address at DNS record. And as you can see, we have here the wildcard domain, wildcard subdomain for our domain amazo.ai, or for you, it might look different, but the IP address must always be the same. And yeah, let me just look through it. And yeah, next, I would say let's set up the reverse proxy as well. So it's good practice to also the reverse DNS, not the reverse proxy. I'm sorry. It was just go to Linode, click on your Linode instance, go on network, and here you see your reverse DNS, which is also again this IP address, but we want to make it a little bit more better. Like it's best practice, what I know, to added also the reverse DNS, reverse DNS. Yeah, just delete this entry here, type your domain name, amazo.ai. So, and say save. And as you can see, it worked. If it didn't work for you, this might not work for everyone because DNS propagation can take some time until it's done. And so make sure that the propagation works properly. This is how you can do it. Like, wait a second. And I would su suggest if you want to see if there are already some records for your domain regarding the DNS, just copy this out. And we need the dig command. I think it must be also for Ubuntu or Linux the same. Just tell you paste your name server and amazo.ai. Here comes your domain, as I said. But the first part dig and ask add ns1.linode.com. What happened here? Did I make a mistake? Copying. Okay. And yeah, this is the my domain. And as you can see, we have quite some entries here. But yeah, the important part is here the answer section. As you can see, this must match with our IP address. So just to make things Just to be sure, just minimize it and look at 143.42.18.230. Okay, that looks good. It looks that DNS propagation was quite fast, but you can also use another name server like the Cloudflare one. 1.1.1.1. This is the name server of Cloudflare. Here's my command, as you can see. And yes, it's my command. And yeah, answer section there we have again the correct IP address. You can do it as well for Google. Just let me clear the screen so you can see it better. And let's make this a bit bigger here. Nice. Let's remove that. This is the Google DNS I'm right now using, 8.8.8 space your domain name. And we have in the answer section something as well that looks very, very good, very promising. And yeah, that's also it for this tutorial. So now the DNS propagation should be done. And next video, we can start to set up our Ubuntu instance and also slowly start up installing Nginx and preparing Nginx web server. So don't forget to like, subscribe, comment down below, and check also the medium.com article. And see you in the next video. Ilalikaya Shabab.